This week in Onuha Uncensored.
Going through the desert with my parents. Safari to us. Safari.
You like your meat pink?
Bro, he said this is the only one in the world. That's a Dior saddlebag of over 30,000 euros.
There it is. Hello. Good?
Yes. Good. We did it again.
Did it again? Clean, man.
Fresh food.
Yes, people. Refresh again. You gotta look good for that weekend, right?
You guys, tell me, what is the trim saying? I'm gonna head to my little brother and my mom and my stepdad. They're here somewhere. My brother just already got his trim. Let's see if I can find them. But my mom and my stepdad, they're having such a good time. They're, of course, overwhelmed with how good Dubai is and everything. It's amazing, you know, to share what is possible in life as well with the people who were good for you at the start, right? Walking through this crazy ass big library. Guys, if there's one thing that is value, then it's self-help, working on yourself. You need good fucking principles to win big in life, right? I started reading books when I was 18. Still, I read books less, however, because I'm so much focused on what I have in front of me, executing. And that's what most people should do. Of course, it's good if you are struggling with certain things to read books, or if you're not getting further, you're looking for answers. But I already know where I'm going. I know what I have to do. So I read books every day, but just a couple of pages. I'm not one of these self-help book junkies. People ask me every time, oh, what is this book? What is that book? Come on, man. You aren't even gonna read it. If I had to give you my top three books right now, it's Outwitting the Devil by Napoleon Hill, No Excuses by Brian Tracy, and The 10X Rule by Grant Cardone. That's how we went 10X, and that's how we went and do millions a month.
Yes, people, back in address. What do you think of the glasses? These daylight glasses, blue light blocking. Gotta biohack some shit, right? Do I look smarter, yes or no? You tell me. Guys, you remember in that vlog where I was fucking going crazy in the bathroom? Funny as hell, man. So I'm back in Address Hotel, here with my parents, with my brother, showing my parents how it works here in Dubai. They're absolutely loving it. So gonna hop into a call right now. Guys, when you make money from your fucking phone or your laptop, one habit I introduced is upgrading your essentials. So about 3 weeks ago, I got a new iPhone. I also shared it in the vlog. I didn't have a clue, because I don't read the news or whatever, that a new iPhone was coming out, iPhone 15. So fuck it, I have a new phone already, but I just copped the iPhone 15 Pro. And I also copped a new MacBook. Here we have the new iPhone 15 Pro. I usually always had the max version, so the bigger ones, but I have multiple phones always, so it's easier for me to have a smaller one. I also type faster. It's important, you know. Also here have the new laptop, 16 inch. I like to work on big laptops. There's my old laptop. So I also have a big iMac screen coming. I ordered that in the Netherlands and I now shipped it to Dubai. So yeah, let me unpack this one. Now gonna jump into this call with Jeroen. Jeroen, amazing guy. He sells supplements. He's the owner of a brand called Modern Native. I've coached him beginning of this year for 3 months. And recently he purchased our one-on-one coaching program again, because we are going to the 500,000 a month. Amazing guy, gonna jump into this call, very humble. I like to coach people like that, you know? People who are go-getters, humble, respectful, because they are the ones who really get the bigger rewards. So let's jump into this thing, feeling good, let's get it. Yes, people, I just came off a call with Jeroen. Amazing guy, really humble, respectful, as I mentioned. Currently doing over 100K with his supplement brand, but not stopping there. It's where we are starting right now. He rejoined the program. We are gonna scale him to 500,000 a month. First target is 300K. Probably will hit it about November or so. Of course, he's dependent on inventory, so that's a major part of it. But we connected him with all the right partners, laid out the strategy. He's gonna kill it. Also had some deeper conversations. Guys, I had a 2-hour long call with Jeroen. I make time for my clients, especially when they come with really amazing questions. I respect my clients, and that's how it is, you know. I see my clients as myself. I really want them, sometimes I want them to succeed more than they want success themselves, but that's why I can be hard sometimes. But guys, it's amazing. Also, what I wanted to share is, of course, I'm here in my apartment. We'll probably show you around later. This is a 3-bedroom apartment. I don't want to talk too much about prices, but again, this is not cheap. At first, I wanted to book a 2-bedroom because it's getting more busy. It's getting more expensive in Dubai. I want to book a 2-bedroom for me and my brother. And then for my parents who are staying for a week, I want to book a hotel room for them here in the Address Hotel. But the hotel was fully booked. And I still wanted to stay here. So what did I do? I booked the 3-bedroom apartment here in the Address Skyview Tower 1. Guys, I'm paying 30,000 a month. For this one, 30,000, no Mickey Mouse money, but I make money, nigga, I make money. And guys, this is accessible for everyone, you know? My parents, they are having such an amazing time here. It's crazy, and you know why I love Dubai? Let me go outside. You know why I love Dubai? I love Dubai because it really has something special, you know? It has something amazing about when you get here, you really are open to reflect on everything. And my parents, they're really sharing with me their journey with me and my brother really succeeding at a higher level. And for them, this is absolutely life-changing. They just seeing in their eyes how much they are enjoying. They are here in Dubai and honestly, they're overwhelmed as shit. Of course, because look around. It's a different world here, man. Dubai is absolutely lovely, but this place has done so much for me, so much. It expands my frame of mind to think fucking big. Guys, this month we're on 2 million a month. Guys, I was on my phone this morning and I got a memory here. 30th of September, so now 4 years ago today, I did 190K in a month. Man, the journey has been amazing. But then I was like, I think we crossed 2 million this month. So I had a look and guess what? $2.1 million this month. How sick is that? How fucking sick is that? Man, when I started my e-com journey, I would have never expected me, just a kid from a small town, to be able to do $2 million in one single month. It's hard for me to really put it at places because the past years have gone so fast as well for me. I know for some of you, these numbers, either for you, you may be inspired a lot. Some they might get hateful about this because they see a kid like me doing this. But at the end of the day, I really want you to look at what I'm doing in my life and think, damn, Samuel started at the same position as me. I'm 24 years old right now. Here, look how big this balcony is, by the way. Here in Dubai, living the life of my dreams. I'm getting better and better every day. I still have a lot of struggles, things I'm dealing with, but that's part of it, right? That's part of it. So what I really want you to take away from this message is work hard, focus on yourself, think fucking big, man. Make money, spend money, share your money, because what this does for everyone around me, for my parents, when I see the enjoyment and the satisfaction in their eyes of their sons, made it happen. We made it fucking happen. I want you to be able to have that same moment with your parents or with your other loved ones, because this is different. I know parents get happy when their son, they finish at high school and gets a little fucking degree. Fuck that shit. That shit is worthless. We wipe our ass with fucking degrees. No degrees. I make 2 million a month and no partner, nobody, no nothing ever asked me what study I did or if I can show them a paper. Fuck that. Parents should be really happy by actual achievements. Finishing school these days or your VMBO or whatever the fuck it's called in English. It is worthless. It doesn't mean anything. We have to stop celebrating things that are worthless. Start celebrating actual things. That's why some people, they get really uncomfortable when I share my life and what I've been able to do, because deep down they fucking know that these are actual achievements. What I achieved is not easy. It is not simple. And that's why we have to start really viewing that as different, guys. It's different, but all of you can do it. Fuck this, your first house or whatever. Fuck it, man. Okay, guys, it's Saturday right now. I think I'm gonna head out for lunch. I just messaged Ruben because he was running for fucking 8 kilometers, man. I said, Ruben, there's no cops here. Stop running, man. What the fuck are you doing? But Ruben, he's still mentally, he's thinking cops are following him or something. He's running for 18 kilometers. What the fuck is that? Just kidding, guys. But message him if he's finished, because then we're gonna get some lunch. I still need to go to the gym. Hectic as fuck. Ruben Filt, 75 hard. I'm thinking I need to start 75 hard as well with him now, or restart it. That's it, guys. We are open about our wins, our losses, our failures. Transparency wins, man. Guys, and one message I want to share with you is that I love all of you guys. I honestly love all of you guys. And that's why I'm able to scream to your fucking face, or to tell you that you're a fucking pussy or a bitch, because I want you to go harder, to do more, to live all of this, what I do. You can do it. But some of you, you need a wake-up call. You need someone like me to spit in your fucking face and tell you, what the fuck are you doing? You need it, because we already have so many soft people telling you it's okay. It's okay that you make the same amount of money as everyone, that you have 2k or 3k a month. It's okay. It's fine. It's fine that you're in your 20s still living with your parents. No, pussy, it's not fine. It's not fine at all, man. It's not fine. When you are watching it, it means you grew up in the West, in a Western world. Come on, come on. God didn't put you on this earth to do nothing. God put you on this earth to be one of his greatest soldiers. And that's what I understand. That's why I'm going so damn hard every day, even when it's painful, even when things are not going my way. I will never ever stop doing this, never, because I'm fucking blessed. You are blessed. Guys, look at what you have already and think like, nah, man, this is not enough. I want more. I want my family and everyone in the world to be impacted by what I am doing. More, guys. More is the answer. I love all of you. Truly love all of you from the bottom of my heart. But I will never, ever comfort your weaknesses. Never. If you are weak by choice, I will tell you to your face that you are soft and that you're a pussy, because it's coming from a place of love. Love ain't lies. I don't lie to you and tell you that it's okay, because it's not. So you should respect a motherfucker like me who tells you straight up in your face that you can do more. Honestly, the people around you who are lying to you and telling you it's okay to be broke, okay to be fat, those are the ones. Those are the disgusting people around you that you need to get rid of. Surround yourself with motherfuckers like me who will tell you you can do more. I only have people in my circle. If I'm lacking, they will tell me straight to my face, Simon, what the fuck are you doing? You can do so much more. Understand the message? I love you guys. Ciao.
Twin bitches, twin Drakes, twin Glock, twin Jets, try to plan.
Yo guys, I'm out here running in Dubai, 18 kilometers. It's hard as fuck, man. I really underestimated it. I'm now at kilometer 13. I really need to stop a few times here and there to get some water, because I really need to get used to the environment. For example, if you run in Amsterdam with like 15 degrees, it's way easier. But now this is definitely good training for the marathon. In running is 37 degrees, almost 40 degrees. Also, yesterday I unfortunately failed my 75 hard on day 33. That happened because I forgot my book, and you always need to read 10 pages every day. And I forgot my book in Amsterdam, so I didn't think of it. I even went to the gym at 2 in the morning. Yeah, shit happens. That's the 75 hard. A lot of people would just ignore it and continue with it and say to people that nothing happened and that they just complete the 75 hard. Nah, man. I cannot lie to myself. So I will still, of course, continue the 75 hard, but I cannot officially complete it. But of course, still proud of myself. I'm already on like day 33 of training every day. So also I'm still continue to do the marathon, of course. I'm running 3 times a week. So for example, this week I on Monday run 8 kilometer, Wednesday 11, and now 18. Yeah, it's going good. In the Netherlands I already got some personal records. Yeah, let's see what Samuel's doing.
Okay guys, I'm going to the gym now. My water, my key, let's fucking have a good training. I was talking with Camille, the training wizard, coming to the gym as well. So guys, it's always good when you're in Dubai to go places where you meet other entrepreneurs. It can be from social media, whatever, but I like to stay in the popular places, you know, because if I am in a place where nobody is, nobody goes, then you really don't walk into people. And here it's quick, it's efficient. Let's go to the gym, left. You can drop your kids if you have some. I don't have kids that I know of. Maybe you have some walking around somewhere in South of America, but as far as I know of, I'm clean.
Welcome to Onuha
Uncensored. There you have it. My card was not working, I don't know why.
I gave my card
to the ship. Okay, thank you. They call him Trading Wizard. It's Trading Wizard.
You know Trading Wizard?
Yeah, you do? You're my biggest fan, eh? No, I know. I'm a big fan of myself, too.
You're in the gym, guys. Clean gym. Just get a quick workout in. Guys, the gym is absolutely beautiful. Hey, Camille, what are those? Ruben, how was the run?
Tough one, very tough one, but we made it. That's more important.
You underestimated it?
I underestimated it, but of course, when you run in 15 degrees in Amsterdam, then 37 degrees will be hard, but I thought it was a bit more easy.
So still 16?
16. My plan was 18, but the route came up to 16, so I cheated a little bit. Next week I will try 20, so it's like every Monday I do 5 or 8, Wednesday 10, and then Saturday I will do 18 or 20.
I said in the vlog beginning today that Ruben, we are in Dubai, you don't have to run from cops anymore.
Yeah, they are faster, they have Lamborghinis.
You now need some food to recharge, you know?
Some chicken.
So let's see. Camille said he's coming down right now. He's in Tower 2. So address has two towers. This time we are in Tower 1. Need some food, man. I haven't had any real substances, only some fruits and some eggs. Of course, that doesn't really fill you up. I think this guy especially needs some food.
You think you're cool with your yellow glasses?
No, I'm not cool, but I'm smart. And I did 2 million this month already, so they don't want to fuck with me. Is that him? I think that's him. There, you see? That's the trading wizard. Camille showed me something in the gym. He was in Rasputin yesterday. Yeah, I told you. I think she unsended.
You think it's the internet?
He thinks it was the internet, but it was unsended.
Huh? Yeah, she unsended.
Maybe.
I think she unsended. Well, on Instagram you can unsend your message.
Yeah, that's what the ladies always do.
Yeah.
I have a wife.
Yeah, a wife and a few girlfriends.
But the, but your wife,
you're a good integrator.
It was a business.
Wife is only for during the weeks and in the weekends you... No?
I'm a loyal
The Quran says something
I'm a loyal one. Welcome to Onuha Uncensored.
This week.
Live from Madrid.
Oh yeah, this week in Onuha Uncensored.
Salafi, 54th floor. Crazy view here, guys. You think of that view, guys. Fucking crazy, right? How they've built everything here. So let's see, we're gonna sit here, but it's 41 degrees, so. But I'm half African, so maybe that will do the job, but. Camille is not. Camille, you said you maybe don't like Dubai anymore.
Yeah.
Why is that?
I just don't want everything to be this perfect.
Yeah.
I like to just walk through the red lights and don't have to think about
you like
it.
A little bit of hair on the pussy.
But you've been here for 3 years, you said.
Yeah, but it's just different. But like now in 3 years, in the beginning it's fun. You see everything. The hospitality is crazy. And in the beginning you really want this. Because you want the new life, the rich life. Now, I just want something new.
You said, was it Budapest?
Yeah,
or something?
Budapest, Florence and Paris or London.
In terms of network, I like it here. And in terms of network, what you have.
But that's what I said. Here you still have a lot of people.
This is the sneaky door.
Talk and take up their money for 1 year. Uh-huh. And then they will spend everything in 1 week. And that's the only week that they are active on social media. You get me?
Yeah, too much flexes with nothing.
Exactly.
Fake flexes. So,
well, try to survive in London for a year or something.
Yeah, that's true, but still in Dubai you can also go to the even more expensive places. We were at Salavi, 54th floor, but it was hot as shit there. Hot as shit, man. So we're like, fuck this. We're going to the Dubai Mall. So, here we are. Ibiza is only for party. Ruben is learning Spanish. Are you doing business in Spain or some different business?
Scaling up multiple things.
Some horny business. But today we are not the smoothest. It's not smooth. This is the fifth restaurant.
Camille, where's the VIP service?
I will fix something.
Guys, Novikov Opso is alright, but Novikov is good. Hi, sir.
Hi.
I'm good, how are you? Inside, okay, I think it's too hot outside. Otherwise, I get sweaty balls.
So, Sam, last time we went to the Dior here in Dubai Mall. We'll tell them what happened.
Yeah, very crazy story. So, I was with Ruben shopping at the Dubai Mall. Obviously, we go to the Dior. So, I always have my saddlebags, right? So, I want a new one, all black. I went inside. I said, do you have an all black saddlebag? He said, I only have one
from behind, but I can get it for you. So he got it. It was like a crazy one with crocodile leather.
And he said, this is the only one in the world.
He said, this is the only one in the world that has this. And me and Ruben, we looked at it like, nah, he's capping. He's probably capping. It's not the only one in the world, probably a sales tactic. I was like, I will first check at some other stores, maybe Fendi, and then come back if I want it. So me and Ruben walked towards Fendi. In the meantime, Ruben is checking online, and he couldn't find it. He couldn't find one who had that.
Also not on StockX, never.
So Ruben said, bro, this is probably really the only one in the world. So we go back, and I walk in. I said, let's do it, man. Let's get this one. So he went back from behind, grabbed the bag, all excited. I'm just there chilling. And I have had many saddlebags before. I think they are like
2.5k.
Euros. At one point, he's gonna pack it. He said, okay, I'm packing it. But he looked very excited in his eyes for some reason. What happened? He comes later with the cash machine, and it says like 135,000 dirhams. So I was like, bro, is this correct? Did you make a mistake with typing it in? I was like, maybe it's 13.5K, it's fine. He looked at me, no, it's 135,000 dirhams. Bro, that's a Dior saddlebag of over 30,000 euros. And I almost purchased it. I already had my card inside, I only had to type my PIN codes. But I was like, fucking hell, man. But that's what happens in Dubai.
It is what it is.
It is.
So, I didn't cop it. Guys, I take care of my money. I'm wise with my money.
Especially with Dom Perignon.
Especially with Dom Perignon, man.
And with the juices, sir, do you also have pussy juice?
Yeah, we do have fresh orange, pineapple, watermelon, red apple.
And pussy juice? No, just kidding. Can I have a watermelon smoothie?
Watermelon smoothie.
Yes, thank you.
He didn't get it.
He didn't get it?
Yeah, no, we have orange juice.
He didn't get it.
We have orange juice.
Guys, we are at Novikov Cafe. Last time I was here, I had the Alaskan King Crab Leg. This one, if you are at Novikov, get this one. Very fucking good. I'm gonna order that one and let's see what else is good. So here we have the tacos, truffle tacos, Ruben's favorite.
Looks like dog food.
It's whiskas with a little truffle on it.
Ah, whiskas.
Yeah,
yeah. Nice. I always ate it when I was younger.
Yeah.
Pink. Like I
You like your meat pink?
Yeah. That's how I like it.
Foul money. Yeah. Here, like this. Pink. Mag het van jou niet iets roze?
Good morning, we're eating good.
Always going. You gotta load up your shit, right?
The carb.
Carbs, fruit.
Some eggs.
Food of the gods. Yeah, man, of course. You gotta live clean, be clean, make your money clean.
Yeah, I showed the people there what all guys are eating. All the cakes and the muffins.
It's October 1st, so what are you gonna do? You gonna start this month winning, or you gonna start this month like a little baby boy again? Losing. Probably eating your cornflakes and that.
Out of shape.
Out of shape. You look in your bank balance yesterday, you're more broke again.
A bit chubby. Your girl ignored you for the second time.
And what did we do, Ruben? What did we do?
We did 2 million a month.
We, 2 million.
We said it before that we are going to reach the goal and we did it.
Guys, you remember when we told you? You remember that? You remember when we put it on the blackboard? Nothing happens by chance. It's all planned and we execute it. Then
perfectly.
It gets happened. That's it.
Yes, guys. Getting that cardio in. Beautiful gym here. The address. See the view. The bush. Guys, you gotta get that work in, right?
Here you see. You see that, nigga? You know what the fuck that is. That's some sweat and a rollie on the wrist.
Guys, one of my favorite quotes is, the more you sweat during peace, the less you bleed during war. So what does that mean? Guys, it's 1st of October. Last month, it's 2 million. What are me and Ruben doing? We are still working around the clock, grinding, sweating during peace, nigga. That's the difference. Most of you people, you sleep on your wins. You make maybe your first 1K, then you go chill, you do nothing anymore. You want that momentum, you want to double down. That's the difference. I really learned this the hard way, guys. I'm not just saying it to say it. I'm saying it because I've fallen flat on my face so many times. But right now, the only way is up. The more you sweat during peace, the less you bleed during war. There's always a storm coming. There's always some war coming, right? Setbacks, obstacles. But if you're prepared, you had enough sweat, easy things.
Guys, just had a killer workout. How great is it that you just have your cold lemon juice here and your frozen towels. Fucking lovely, man. So I'm gonna go to the desert with my parents this afternoon. Gonna show them some some good experience.
Guys, when you make money, it's the finer things in life. The little things, the cold towels. After you've sweated like a motherfucker, that are the things you work for.
Some pre-desert food. We need that.
Looks good, right, Ruben?
Very good.
Need that energy, man. Going to the desert with my parents. Don't know exactly what we're gonna do.
Ruben knows.
Yeah. Safari tour.
Safari tour for the tourist.
The tourist thing, you know? Cannot take my parents to the club, right? ATL, Jacob,
you pray for my demons, girl, I got you. Every time I sip on codeine, I get vulnerable. Annoying the sounds of the storm when it comes. She understand I can't take her everywhere a nigga going. I've been in the field like the children of the corn. I can hear your tears when they drop over the phone. Get mad at yourself cause she can't leave me alone. So get messy, it ain't what we doing.
Guys, so we here at Sushi Samba right now. Looking at the menu with my parents. View here is amazing. View of the palm. This is on the 51st floor. So yeah, let's have some good dinner. My parents fly back to Amsterdam later tonight.
Need to tell a real one exactly what it is.
Next time in Onuha Uncensored.
One is not enough. So let's see.
A little coconut for the win, you know? Cheers, bro.
Show the people how you can also airdrop. Puff. Bang.